Welcome back. So, having introduced to the concept of available energy, unavailable energy, now I want you to take a further step. Look at this. This is something which we have already, explained, right? So, I have just redrawn something which was known to you. So here, heat was given to the Carnot engine by the source. That means it's a source, means it's of infinite heat capacity. So no matter how much heat you take from it, its temperature won't drop. It was given to Carnot engine, obviously reversibly, at temperature T. So Carnot engine received the heat at temperature T. Carnot engine also had same temperature. That means some imaginary working substance in the Carnot engine was also at temperature T when it received the heat. Now let's say, and you know, from this we have represented this will be available energy, this will be unavailable energy, all that is known to you, right? Okay, previous video. So now let's say that the heat, Q1 amount of heat, right? Q1 same amount of heat. Now, what happens is from this source, it goes to some other body, which is at a lower temperature than this. That means it is not going to Carnot engine. Instead of going to Carnot engine, this heat Q1, let's say Q1, goes to some other body which is at temperature T dash, which is as temperature T dash. So T dash is less than T. So what has happened? There is irreversible heat transfer, because heat transfer has taken place across finite temperature difference. So heat now, same amount of heat is now received by the body which is at a lower temperature. Now from here you would like to find out. So heat is now not at T, but it is at T dash. Okay, heat is available from T dash, and now you want to find out how much is the available energy of that amount Q1. Okay, that means what will you do? You will now run a Carnot engine between T dash and T naught, because T naught is the lowest temperature, it's the sink temperature. So you will run a Carnot engine between T dash and T naught. So let's say we run a Carnot engine. This is amount Q1, same Q1, please note, Q1 is same. Now this is, but it is now coming from a source which is at temperature T dash. And why? Because there is irreversible heat transfer. It's not directly going to Carnot engine, but it's going to this body, and then you run a Carnot engine to find out available energy. So then you have T naught. Now you want to find out available energy. Okay, now this available energy will be less than this available energy. Why? Simple. This available energy was what? It was heat supplied into efficiency of this, right? Heat supplied into efficiency. Now here, this available energy, so we can write here, this available energy, I'll write this as AE1, right? Which was Q1 into efficiency of this. What was efficiency of this? T minus T naught upon T, right? T minus T naught upon T. Now here, if you want to find out available energy here, let's say 2, what will be available energy here? It will be Q1, that is heat supplied in a Carnot engine. So it is available energy 2 will be Q1 into efficiency of this Carnot engine is T dash minus T naught upon T naught. Here it was, sorry, T dash minus T naught upon T dash. Now just think about this, obviously. So this is T, So this is, you can see, this is T minus T naught upon T. It is T dash minus T naught upon T dash. Now see, this efficiency term obviously is less, because this source temperature is less. So this efficiency term is reduced. Amount of heat is same in both the cases. So what has happened? What has happened is available energy, which you will get here, will be less than this. Okay? Which will be less than this. So if I draw the same, this process on the same plane, right? How will it look? Just think about it. I'll make use of another color. So Q1, now you have temperature T dash, heat supplied is Q1, represented here. So if this were were T and this was T naught. Now I will, this is the lower temperature, T dash is lower temperature, let's say this is T dash. Now heat is supplied to the engine and we'll start from here. Okay, heat is supplied. Now see, what is the change in entropy? Now see, this is again a Carnot engine. Remember, this is a Carnot engine, but Carnot engine operating between T dash and T naught. So when heat is added to it, entropy is going to increase of the working substance here, like heat here increase, but now this increase is greater. Why? Because heat, entropy increase is what? Q1 upon T, because heat received is Q1, temperature is T. Now here is Q1 upon T dash. T dash is what? Temperature of the working substance as well as the source. Here it is, T is the working substance temperature as well as the source, because it is reversible heat transfer. So entropy change is going to be Q1 upon T dash. T dash in the denominator is a smaller term, whereas Q1 upon T, T is a higher term, a larger term than T dash. So Q1 upon T dash is entropy change, which will be higher. Please note, Q1 upon T dash will be higher. So now the entropy change will be delta S dash. So here is somewhere, if this is 1 dash, this is 2 dash. I am drawing this cycle. Now remaining process, it comes down. This is, so here it is delta S dash, this also will be delta N dash. So it is 3 dash comes back to 4. Okay, 3 dash comes back to 4. So you have this, this was your initial cycle, this is your new cycle. See what has happened. Now, if you see, what is the heat rejected now? What is the heat rejected? Heat rejected is from 3 to 4. So this is your entire heat rejected, which is unavailable energy. You can see that earlier unavailable energy was this, now it has increased. So unavailable energy has increased, that means here your Q2 dash heat rejected is more. Why? Because available, you have extracted, you are able to extract less work out, because efficiency here is less, because it is T dash and not T. So available energy Q2 dash is more than Q2 here. Q2 was this. Now Q2 dash is the new available energy, unavailable energy, which is more than the earlier. And you can also see, what about the available energy? Available energy now in the new case is this, this entire area. And this area will be less than this area. So what has happened? What has happened is the available, so if you find out available energy from here, if you want to write down this, it is in the new case, I will write this as AE2 here. Available energy is Q1 minus, Q1 is the total heat, see total, what area under the process line 1 dash to 2 dash, entire area is Q1, okay? Heat supplied in both the cases is same. Heat supplied in both the cases is same. So, I am talking about the new cycle. Here we will see 1 dash to 2 dash, total heat supplied is Q1. Heat rejection is this. This area is heat rejection. So, what is that heat rejection? Now you can see, it is Q2 dash. So Q1 is T dash into delta S dash. T dash into delta S dash. This is the total area minus Q2 dash. This area, Q2 dash. It is T naught into delta S dash. So it is T naught into delta S dash. So available energy here, you can say it is T dash minus T naught into delta S dash, right? Delta S dash. So you can see earlier available energy and this available energy, obviously, as we have seen, this available energy 1, this available energy 2, that is the same available energy in the form of delta S dash and T. So this and this are same. So what you can see here is the new available energy is less than the earlier available energy. What do you mean by that? It means that because of irreversible heat transfer from 2 to T dash, the quantity of heat has remained same. Q1, this is also supplied with Q1, this engine is also supplied with Q1. But the work output from this engine has reduced. That means the quality of heat has gone down. Less of that heat is converted into work. So because of this irreversible heat transfer, there is loss of available energy. There is loss of available energy. How much is the loss of available energy? If you can look here, you can see. In the first blue rectangle, you can see the heat rejected was this much, right? This much was the heat rejected. Now how much is the heat rejected? This much is the heat rejected. So there is extra heat rejected. How much is that extra heat rejected? This I can show here. This is this square, right? This is or rectangle, whatever. This is your extra heat rejected. That means this is the drop in available energy. This is the drop in available energy. So decrease in available energy, decrease in available energy because of irreversible heat transfer is shown here. Okay, this is the extra heat that has. So this engine is rejecting here Q2. Here it is rejecting Q2 dash. Q2 dash is more than Q2. So Q2 dash minus Q2 is the decrease in available energy. If this extra heat were not rejected, this would have been available over here and this would have been equal to this. But that's not the case because here efficiency has reduced. So a decrease in available energy is represented by this square or rectangle. And that is how much is that? This is T0. And what is this? This is nothing but delta S dash minus delta S. This is delta S dash. This is delta H. So this is, this you can write as T0 into delta S dash minus delta S. T0 into delta S dash minus delta S. This is the decrease in available energy or increase in unavailable energy. One and the same. Think about it. This is because of irreversible heat transfer. Okay? So the point is, when there is heat is transferred irreversibly, its quality goes down and less of it can be converted into work. Thank you.